Speed wins out, Devontae Smith wins out, you have a better talent in Devontae Smith than you have in Ruggs. In this new NFL, I know he's 165 pounds, 170 pounds, if you're stretching him, you know, best you can. But in this new NFL, when you're getting receptions on jet sweeps where the quarterback just slipped you the ball, or you're throwing balls behind the line of scrimmage 20% of the time for receptions, you can use a guy like that, and he can make it in the NFL. Whereas before, it was more difficult. You know, he reminds me somewhat of DeSean Jackson. I always call him a great football player with track speed, as opposed to most of these fast guys who are track guys that's trying to play football. And you remember DeSean Jackson years ago when the league was like Houston, when it was old league, was running a zero route, an under route, and they cracked DeSean Jackson. And I thought he was never going to play again. But you can't do that anymore. So Devontae Smith can move and play in this league. But if you ask me, my first choice would be Ja'Marr Chase. You know, a big dude that has great transition. I mean, this dude transition, I think his shuttle time was something. The only person that came close to him was like Amari Cooper. And the first thing that pops off to me with Amari Cooper is his ability to get in and out of cuts. Now, Ja'Marr Chase is a big dude, get in and out of cuts like that. So I like him also. And Waddle, when I see a guy in this league, in this day and age, where I get dudes tapping on their damn helmet on 3rd and 8 to come out of a game. Like, I'm like, dude, it's 3rd and 8. How can your hand make contact with your helmet like you want to come out of the game right now? What's wrong with you? You know what I mean? Well, it's 3rd and 8. So in this generation, this kind of dude, Waddle gets you tapping your helmet to come out on 3rd and 8. This dude out here playing on a broken leg. That's what I want, a dude that want to play no matter what, and he wants to play no matter what, and that's why I love him.
Mike, you know, I wanted to ask you about this because, you know, two of the guys the Cowboys are thought of to be in contention for are Surtain and Horn, both children of former athletes, former NFL players. And, you know, Jerry had mentioned that he believes that they can learn the game through osmosis. What's your experience been with kids of former players? And I know you had mentioned, like, you know, the Instagram generation, they're already famous before they even get to the league. Instead of being famous for championships or famous for, you know, being athletes, you know, but you know, kids of former players, they're already famous because of their name.
Yeah, but they also have a certain push to them. You know, some of those kids, you know, they want to match or beat what their parents have done. You know what I mean? And that's the drive. That's the drive. You're looking for kids with drives, whatever drives you. I don't care. You want to be rich? As long as it drives you crazy to get played like you want to play on this field, I want you. You want to be famous? As long as it drives you on this field, I want you. You want all the women? I don't care. As long as it drives you on this football field, I want you. And that's a great drive for those two. And when we start talking about those two, you ask me, Michael, with both of them sitting there, which one you want? I'm going to tell you why I take Patrick Surtain. Because he is the one who talks to Trayvon Diggs all the time. I want the mentality set. I want the person that you're sitting there talking with, talking about doing great things. When I ask him about man in the corners, I said, how many times have you and Diggs talked about it? He said, we talk about it all the time. I want you dreaming about it before you get here and then walk out that dream right here for me. Because both of them are good. Both of them are good. So I'm looking for that edge. And I'm telling you guys, I'll take a guy that has something for me, shoulders up. Well, you know, these guys wanting to be great together, talking about it, everything. That little thing, shoulders up, when the talent, physical talent, shoulders down, is very comparable. I'll take the guy that has a little more edge, shoulders up. And I think that's Patrick Surtain because of his relationship with Diggs.
Michael, I want to hear the rookie symposium speech from you. All these kids that you, I know Dion, mentors, when you get on the phone with them for the first time, or if we're those kids and we say, what do we need to know? What's your best piece of advice with all the success you had, with the negative turns that you had? What is the Michael Irvin rookie speech that you give that you hope sticks with these guys the most?
You know what? The one thing that I try to talk, especially about with these young kids, is this, and this is the reality of it. I said, man, work hard. You're going to do and have great success professionally. But make sure you're working hard to strive and get better personally. You got to think about it this way, guys. Most of these guys are coming from some tough situations, some tough backgrounds, and we'll see it all play out tomorrow. I'm on that red carpet, man. Watch how many guys come through there in that red carpet, just realizing their dream is about to come true. I get ready to ask questions. I see people crying. I can't believe I'm here. I can't believe I'm talking to you right now, Michael. and the mom right there with them. And mom, I told you I'm going to get you here. And you can see the tears coming out their eyes. You know, I'm going to buy you a house. It's the moment. I had that moment. I couldn't believe I was here now and all that hard work. And mama, I'm gonna buy you this house that I promised I'm going to get you. So now, if we're coming from tough places, that means we're bound to make some mistakes because we're just not mature enough, hadn't seen enough, and now we're finna get everybody attacking us. So I'm telling you, as you make great strides professionally, make sure you're working on yourself personally so you don't have some situations.